A very good day to you. And this time round, in our session, we're going to talk about essential PCB design using IPC standards. This is a three-day course, and in this course, we will be focusing on introducing IPC standards to our customers and participants who have little or no knowledge about what are these things. So, first thing is one of the most simplest way to discuss about IPC standards is this performance class 1, 2, 3, which is in this course we will let you know like how can you specify different performance class to your vendor in order for them to fab the board, assembly, test and qualify the boards. At the same time, in the course we also are interested to look at level ABC. And we find that a lot of time customers sometimes are confused about the difference between class 1, 2, 3 and level ABC. As in, what's the difference? Do we have to qualify level ABC? Actually, the answer is no, because level ABC is for manufacturing communication purposes only. And sometimes they just means that it's the tolerance involved. Like for example, level A means that it is easier for you to fab the board. So sometimes customers do tend to get confused and they tell us that, oh, their customers wanted to QA or QC level A, which is not possible. All right. So in this course, we make a very clear explanation on how you can use it properly. Right. After getting to know introduction about the IPC standards, the next thing we will go through is we will show you video sessions. The video sessions will involve how you manufacture a multi-layer PCB board, as well as we will show you the SMT assembly process, so in a video. So in this case, it's much easier for you to, you know, imagine what it is like by looking at the video, and then we discuss the important points regarding manufacture, assembly, test. And then the last item we have is design for reliability. And this topic here is whereby many of the customers are very interested, because sometimes, just take for example, our customer can come from an ATE environment, and in ATE testing environment, they are very interested in reliability, but because the board, the PCB board or the test board has to go through extreme temperature. So they need to design such that the board will be able to sustain the high temperature cycling without failing too fast, right? So in this kind of design for reliability, we normally have a recommended checklist, and the checklist will have, for example, we introduce you on how you can select the components based on packaging, board materials, like what sort of board materials will have better quality to handle extreme temperatures or shock and vibration. And then we talk about stack up configuration, aspect ratio of PTH, the thermal impacts that you get, as well as solder joint. And the last item, the lamp pattern, which is most of our customers are interested, because the lamp pattern will actually affect the solder joint quality. So lamp pattern is actually driven by process and also driven by application. So this is where, you know, we discuss design for reliability in a lot more detail, and then with respect to the IPC standards. At the same time, in this course, we also add in something which most of the designers these days have to know, which is the signal integrity introduction. So things, common things like impedance design, right? How you can lower the impedance, or how does crosstalk are being reduced, etc., etc. So topics like this are much in demand, but here we give you an overall introduction, and hopefully that with this information you will find that you can apply to your job and your everyday design activities or manufacturing activities. So with that, we hope that this short little intro can give you an idea. And then perhaps if you like to join the class, please do contact Wizlogix, and then maybe see you next time. Thank you very much.